Yes, and if you are now joining us, this is Super League action. FC Santo Petrin. Long kick downfield. That's Tigana Sparks, but intercepted again there by skipper Griffith. That's Kern Peters. Henry. Henry inside to Sparks. Sparks maybe a little bit maybe too fancy. And Sparks loses it. It's back with Santa Rosa. That's Henry. And it's a break here for Santa Rosa, but it's quickly broken up there. And Tian Tech trying to go forward. And Captain Griffith. And some very strong. That's Aguilera. Aguilera formerly of Point Fortis Civic. So a number of quality players here on this Petrin team. That's Kevin Mark in goal for Petrin. Tigana Sparks. Sparks inside to Aguilera. Aguilera goes past one. But maybe holding on a bit too long is Aguilera. None of the goalkeepers has been tested as yet. A good ball there inside. For Sparks. Sparks has one, floats across the face of the and Smek comes in but was not in total control. That's Akwi looking to get Kieran Clark is back with Sandy, and it's going to be a free kick. So that's Henry. Not what I thought they had anticipated. That's Wayne. Wayne advances down the half line. Still as it is Wayne. A true ball, that's Shaquille Williams. Maybe didn't expect the pass or was not in control of his own 2 feet, but a great opportunity there for Petrin to take the lead. Aguilera sends it long, looking for Speck. But again, good defending by Jesse Reyes for Santa Rosa. It's an opportunity here for Sandy, but again, Kirsten Henry, in comes the corner, but free kick to Santa Rosa, deep inside the half of the field, ball comes up, and it's an opportunity here, and there was a call. Again, we've seen some opportunities being wasted here. And well, coming to the party is Rashad Griffith. And certainly there was total miscommunication between the defenders and goalkeeper for that's Kevin Martin. Is Rashad Griffith the captain? So it took 20 minutes of football here at the Petrichin Recreation Ground to see the first goal scored. And I think from here we're going to be seeing or getting a very exciting game here, because Petrichin have to come from behind now. Remember, they are on a two-game winning streak, and it's an opportunity here for well, again, well, that is the closest that Petrichin have come thus far to opening the scoring or to level the scoring. Keston Henry, in comes the corner, again taking on the second attempt there by the goalkeeper for Keston Henry, the man giving the responsibility. In comes inside the goal, and the whistle. And we see Coach Cyrus. Matura United. And again, and a card is going to be issued, and it's going to be given to that player, that's John. Petrichin still giving up a lot of free kicks in. It's going to be quickly taken. Is he good defending? Goal kick. Well, Rashad Griffith is up, but moving very gingerly, so it's going to be left up to looking to get Lester Edwards. But again, goalkeeper quicker to the ball, actually. So it's a break here by Santa Rosa. That's Akwi. But Akwi is taken out there. But it's no infringement, and the ball goes back to FC Santa Rosa. So Santa Rosa, after scoring the goal, seem to have taken their foot off the brakes. And has gone back to stalemate, as it was in the opening before the goal was scored. So not much here to get the supporters excited. In comes the throw-in. Good stroke. Back with inside to Sparks, but so try as they may, Petrichin still not being able to level the scoring. Thank you. Quickly taking a free kick by Smek. So an attack from the Petrotrin team here on the coming by goalkeeper Manning. And that's the end of the first half. Well, not what we will say consider an exciting 45 minutes. Nevertheless, Rashad Griffith putting his team up ahead, so Santa Rosa FC leading 1-0. So we're going to take a break at 18. We're going to give you the final minute, 45 minutes of this game. Petrotrin Palo Seco versus FC Santa Rosa. And that's the sound of the whistle. Second half action. Kern Peters. Getting his first touch here is Darren Alexis. An infringement that goes against Petrotrin. Deep into the Petrotrin half of the field. That's Edwards. Turns, looking for Rashad. And playing it dangerously in the defense there is Petrotrin. It's only as far as Sheldon Nesbitt. Santa Rosa, on the other hand, looking to extend their lead. That's Martin. Claro there. Straight into the arms of Martin. Martin has shown a clean pair of hands so far. So Santa Rosa coming off their win against Betel in round two. Beating Betel 4-2, having drawn their first game. Petrotrin, on the other hand, have won their last two encounters, but they are trailing here. And an opportunity here, and it's Akwi, and broken up there, but still finally cleared out there by the, that's John. And the supporters and the players FC Santa Rosa have sends it straight inside the 8-yard box. Good defending there by Skipper Rashad, but it's back with Petrotrin. So no amount of firepower we are seeing from the Petrosian team as yet. But it's an opportunity here for the, that's Alexis. Another player is down, but this time it's in a very interesting position once again for Petrosian. One thing I could mention, that there are more people, persons here at this game, supporters, spectators, than you will see anywhere in. And it's an opportunity, and it's a goal. And Renford Martin has equalized for his team, Petrosian. Coming out of, I must eat my words, because I was saying a while ago that Petrosian seems to have lost their way. Petrosian lift their game here after scoring. That's Aguilera. Aguilera is bundle of the ball. Referee appeared to be going for his whistle, but changed his mind. And infringement, but a good attack there by the Petrosian team. And the action is on ACTN, and you're watching Tuesday Night Football. That's a good, maybe a bit too strong there for Alexis. But a good cross nevertheless coming from the boot of Shaquille Henry. Maybe a bit too much power, but the intention was a good one. So it's back with goalkeeper Manning. Ketwana Manning. Williams. Well, the referee has started the game, and there are still the player and the coach on the field, so I don't think the referee will get passing grades here for this match. And into the arms of Martin. That's Aguilera to Edwards. And Aguilera a bit too slow there, and it's an opportunity, and it comes off the bar, and Petrosian lives to fight another day here. Antoine John, formerly of Presentation College. That's Alexis. What, to no one in particular. That's John. John there. Rez on the sideline. An opportunity for Petrosian, but so the last couple of minutes has seen the pace quicken, and it's an opportunity. And well, a penalty is given, but it appears that there was some contact. So it's the skipper Rashad Griffith with the opportunity to see his team take the lead and also to score the double. And in comes, and it's 2-1 in favor of Santa Rosa. Peters, Alexis, long up front, but again, the passes inside to the Petrotrin strikers, not on target. Goalkeeper Manning having somewhat easy time. Santa Rosa, Griffith goes past two. Kern Peters. Inside to Shaquille. Shaquille goes past one, sends it across the field, but could defend in from the. That's Jesse Reyes for Santa Rosa. But take nothing from Santa Rosa. They have been defending. I see some timely saves from the goalkeeper. Petrotrin needs to get that ball quicker up front. They are trailing. Looking to get Alexis, but again, the chemistry up front is not working. Some good crosses, but all has been going straight. So trying to put some pressure here, Palo Seco, and trying to kill some time. And well, what we didn't get in the first half and part of the second half, we are picking it up here this afternoon in the last 10 to 15 minutes. And skipper coach Cyrus cannot even watch the game. And it's 2 goals apiece. So keep an eye on his clock. That was definitely infringement there. The hands of the number three, the number 23, that's Charles. So what a game we have had here in the second half. The last 5 to 10 minutes, a lot more action. So anxious moment here for both coaches. Straight into the 18-yard box. And well, that is all I can see. And now the coach is, he has gotten his voice. He has gotten his voice. And that's the, and Santa Rosa, and we see the coach, like he is, I don't know who he is praying to, but he remind me of Laros Corrin's hundreds, and he's now attacking the supporters. Nevertheless, it end up an exciting game in the last couple of minutes. Santa Rosa with the victory over Petrotrin.